Sandy Missouri from Balloon Utopia and Market with Balloons, and today we are making organic helium clouds. Whew. Normally I don't show you helium stuff, but I have been asked about this, and there's a little bit of a PETA factor to it. We're in a ballroom where they are really worried about balloons going up to the ceiling, because they have kind of an unfinished, straight up to the air conditioning ducts. So that makes it all the more challenging. So let me show you what we're starting with here. I've got two ribbons. I'm putting each one on two ribbons, both for the stability and also just extra color. I've got the fun sparkly ribbon. And we're starting with the 16 inchers. So I'm going to inflate a pair of 16 inchers here. And our color scheme, you may have noticed, is blues and silvers. Now, when we do normal organic, because we absolutely need the lift ability, we want these to actually be pretty full, not so much rounded. And of course, the challenge is to hold on to them while you're doing the next thing. And that's really the challenge in all of this, more than anything else, is just not losing our helium balloons, because we're working with them at times untethered. Okay, so you see I made my first duplet, and I'm actually going to tie the ribbon onto it to make it really secure. Now, my next set is gonna be another 16 inch. Here, you wanna come around a little bit this way? That way I don't have to keep turning. Hey, hi. All right, another 16 inch and a 12 inch. And so here too, we want them full, but not to the dangerous place. And 16-inch balloons are so much fun to tie. Don't you just love it when they sit there hitting you? Yeah, love it. All right, so then we're just twisting it in just like we would any normal quad. But then, just to make sure, we're taking our ribbon and also kind of figure-aiding it around, trying to make sure that everything's good and secure. Okay, what I'm gonna do with this now is, you see, we're kind of assembly lining it. We're doing the centerpiece first, and then we're going to add to it. But just for the sake of you guys on camera here, and also just for fun, we got some chrome balloons, new chrome, yay! Let's look at those. Here we have regular silver, and let's look at the chrome silver. See the difference there? And here's the chrome blue. Okay, so here is what becomes a bit of a challenge. It's we're going to kind of make this cluster here, and then we want to tie it to a piece of a 260. And here's where it gets really hard, because it's really easy to lose your fingering on it and then the balloons gets away. So now I'm holding on to this 260 while I inflate another balloon little cluster, and I'm going to tie in a pearl balloon here. Okay, so I have this, and now because I'm really worried about losing it, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna tie it in to this cluster here, but as I'm tying it in, you see I'm like kind of wrapping this, the 260 figure eighting it around, and now I'm gonna maintain control of it because I'm gonna wanna tie more balloons to it. Because I don't want this to look like a big topiary ball, I want it to be organic and weird shaped. So, and actually, I think what I'm even going to do is I'm just going to tie that first balloon directly to that so I don't have to try to hold on to it. And now keep making my duplets and stuff around this. Okay, so now I can let go. Feeling a little bit better about it. And you see, we really have to use those balloons fairly fully inflated, which is really kind of a departure from what we normally do. And we're just going to kind of keep building it out this way. I mean, because it's organic, we don't know where we're going with it in the end, you know? We just kind of do it until it looks about right. So we'll just keep building on and adding on to it. Let me do a couple more of the 11-inch clusters, and then we'll move on to putting some 5-inchers in it. So you see that we have a couple of linky balloons that we're gonna add into it. Let's add another linky here, just for fun. Again, again, just kind of gets a different texture. Some different shaking to it. Some different problems with it. Have your balloons pre-cut so you don't have to do what I'm doing. And the scariest part of it is when you're tying that first one on, right? Because that's when you're most likely to lose it. So once you get it attached into the cluster, it's not necessarily as dangerous. I know it's kind of hard to see what I'm doing back here. But this is one of those real videos that you guys like when I'm actually on the job site and not in studio. Don't you love just wrestling with it? This is where I wish I was like a 7-foot guy, you know? With like really long arms. Everybody's awake now, right? That was just our sound check. Should we put a... Yeah, I think we should put a chrome right here. All right, so once we have like our basic kind of random cluster going here, then what we're gonna do is we're gonna take our 5-inchers. Now we've already pre-prepared these, and if you guys have seen my other organic videos, this is just the same, that what we have is we have half of a 260 with random size, shape, 5-inchers attached, and we're literally just going to kind of work it in somewhere. And then we don't have to be as careful with these because, of course, if they come loose, they're just gonna fall down to the ground. But we wanna, gosh, I wish we had chrome of these. So yeah, these we don't have to worry about as much. If they come off, you know, they're just gonna drop. We don't have to be as careful. Doing the 11-inchers when you're tying those in, that's kind of nerve-wracking, not gonna lie. Especially when you're in a venue that's really worried about them getting up to the ceiling. So, I don't know, we're probably gonna put 3 or 4 or 5 of these in. And then of course we want some tied onto our linkies. Oh, that one. Hey, look at that. I really like these chrome balloons. They're not paying me to say that either. They should, but they're not. I especially like the chrome balloons when they're used with other balloons so that the texture really comes out. Let's see, we had another linky on this one, I think. Oh, there it is. All right. Let's just inflate a couple of these real quick. That third hand here. Just need a couple more hands, that's all. Do not do this at home. Yes, this is what a real job looks like. They're messy. They are messy. And then, so we do that, we're gonna tie this on. So yeah, we don't want to count too much on the links, right? That's why I have the 5 inches on it, because they'll just fall to the ground. But I don't want to attach 11 inches to it, because I would just be worried then that if it did break, that something would get up to the ceiling. So basically, I think we probably need some more 5 inches stuck in and around this, just to keep getting that texture. And also to hide the strings a bit more. So yeah, essentially, there we go. All the clouds will be kind of different, as you can imagine. Like, I think I might still want to build out this way or whatever. And then, let's come over here. Here we can see this. So there it is, our organic cloud cluster. And then to weight it down, we're actually using these 2.5 pound weights, because they've got some lift to them, and we want to make sure they're good and stable. And then, of course, we'll wrap the weights. We won't leave them ugly like this. But I'll take some pictures when it's all done, so you can see the whole room, and I'll put it in the back. But here, we'll come back over here. So yeah, there you go. This is the organic cloud with the chrome balloons. And that's it for today's video. Now remember, if you like this video, you stop it? No, okay. If you like this video, make sure you subscribe, make sure you tell your friends about it, make sure that you hit like, and also leave me a comment. Tell me what else you want to see. I'll keep making some more of these impromptu videos besides the studio videos. And until next time, go forth and balloonify!